My name is Bennett, and it is my absolute pleasure to welcome you back at this historic time to the New York Aquarium. In 2012, the aquarium was devastated by Superstorm Sandy. But we've spent the past 10 years recovering, and guess what? We are now finally happy to say that we are back, fully restored, and better than ever before. So, we want to thank you all for our tremendous support. Thank you all so much. And now, it is my pleasure to welcome and introduce you all to the stars of our show. Give it up for 2-year-old sea lion, Marco, and his trainer, Jen. And we've also got another 2-year-old sea lion, Erie, and his trainer, Sarah. Now, Marco and Erie are California sea lions. California sea lions can be found all along our west coast, as far north as Canada, and as far south as Mexico. Sea lions are very social animals. They gather in large groups called rookeries, and these rookeries can be very noisy places. Males vocalize to claim and defend their territory, while females vocalize to identify their pups on a crowded beach. Now, sea lions can also identify each other with something called a breath exchange, which looks a whole lot like a sea lion kiss. So, sea lions are part of a large group of mammals called pinnipeds. This group includes harbor seals that you can find at sea cliffs, sea lions like Marco and Erie, and walruses. Now, I bet everybody knows what a walrus looks like, you know, with the two front tusks and everything. But spotting the difference between a seal and a sea lion is a bit trickier, so here are a few tips to help you do just that. Look to the side of the animal's head. If you see an ear flap, you're looking at a sea lion. Seals do not have those. Seals have very short front flippers, while a sea lion's front flippers are long and flexible. They use this to help pull them through the water, very similar to how humans do when they swim. Now, sea lions use their rear flippers for steering, and these rear flippers are super floppy. These rear flippers also rotate underneath them, which make them very mobile on land. So, this is going to bring Marco and Erie's portion of the show to an end, but don't worry, we'll be joined by another sea lion shortly. But how about another round of applause for Marco and Erie? Now, just in case you were wondering, yes, our jobs are as amazing as they seem. We are honored to work with all these magnificent animals that you see here and thrilled to share that connection with you all. Here. And now please join me in welcoming 13-year-old sea lion Bruiser and his trainer, Jen. Everybody, give it up for Bruiser. Now, fish and fun are easy to come by here at the aquarium, but in the wild, things are a little bit different. In the wild, a sea lion has to catch their own fish, and all the while, there is another predator just waiting to catch them, prowling the waters, stalking their quarry, just waiting for the perfect moment to strike. You know what it is. It's the sea lion's primary predator. Say it with me, the great white. Okay, very funny you two. There are no sharks in the aqua theater. And yes, sea lions are preyed upon by sharks and killer whales, but this is serious stuff. All marine life faces an even bigger threat. And it's not a predator, it's plastics. The plastics we use wind up in our waters where they can trap and kill millions of animals, including sea lions, sharks, rays, seabirds, sea turtles, all kinds of animal life. And I'm not just talking about these big pieces of plastic. Jen, what is that? a plastic bottle and it was in the pool?
It was.
Oh, this is so embarrassing. I'm sorry, everyone. I'm just going to take this and put it right in the trash. What is it, Bruiser? Trash, plastic belongs in the recycling. Nice catch, buddy. High five. So, as I was saying, plastics. Hey, wait a minute. I checked the pool 10 minutes before the show and it was perfect. How could a plastic bottle have gotten in there? Unless someone put it in there, Jen. Well, if it wasn't you, and it wasn't me, then who did it? Bruiser, did you put the plastic in the pool? Okay, Bruiser, it's never okay to put plastic in the pool. I think you all need a time out. Go on. Time out time. You heard me. It's never okay. Oh, what? We're being so sad now? Okay, very dramatic. Are you guys playing music? You're playing music right now? This is so, okay, come on. Okay, maybe I was a little bit too harsh, but this is serious stuff. Plastic is choking our waters. Did you know that every year people use over 50 billion plastic bottles? And of that number, only 1 in 5 get recycled.
1 in 5!
1 in 5! That's right, Bruiser. It's shocking. But if Jen and I and everyone here commits to using a reusable bottle instead of a plastic one, we could save countless of animal lives. Each and every one of us has the chance to make a difference, and that is something. Everybody give it up for Bruiser! New York is a big city, but it's also a coastal community. A series of islands surrounded by a vast ocean wilderness. And it is the choices that we make that help protect this underwater world. Thank you so much for coming to the aquarium. Remember, when you support us, you support the worldwide efforts of the Wildlife Conservation Society. Please stay in your seats, because in just a few moments, we'll be taking it to the booth to help you all exit the Aqua Theater safely. But how about another round of applause for the stars of our show? Give it up for Osborne, Marco, Erie, Bruiser, Pickles, and their children, Jen and Sarah! Sound booth, take it away!
All right, everyone, give it up for Bennett! We ask that everyone in the bleachers remain seated to allow the guests in accessible seating to exit first. If you are in accessible seating, we invite you to make your way towards the exits now. Anyone who requires a ramp can exit through exit 2. If you are seated in the bleachers, please remain seated until everyone in accessible seating has exited the Aqua Theater.
Now, Parker is demonstrating that first fish for us really great. So that's a capelin. It's our smaller, leaner fish. We also have what's called a herring, which he's going to show off for us again here. And that's a lot bigger and a fattier fish. And then we also can feed them squid. But another really fun thing they can eat is Jell-O. Now, it's a little bit different than the Jell-O we eat. It doesn't have all the yummy flavors. It's just a little bit of gelatin and a lot of water. And it helps give them some fun things to chew on, but also helps provide hydration. Everyone, you guys can wave at him. Mark's actually going to be leaving, and we're going to be getting our next guest for you guys. Do you have any questions about Clark? No, he's like so great. What questions can we have, right? We're going to be joined by our 8-year-old rescue sea lion, Townsend, and you'll be able to see that size difference I was talking about. Whoa. So everyone can say hello to him. So I was just telling them all about the amazing husbandry that we do for our animals and how we check them all on their full body. So we can see Sarah's going to look at his flippers and make sure everything looks really great. We can even look inside their mouth and get a better look at those teeth. You can see those ones real good, right? Look at their back and their belly. And this is how we can look at all of their rear flippers and everything. Now, we can even have more complex husbandry behaviors. So our animals actually voluntarily participate in their own blood draws, injections, ultrasounds, and we can even brush their teeth, just like you would brush your own teeth. They get their own fish-flavored toothpaste. So you can see here, Townsend's actually getting some eye drops, so we can show you guys that amazing husbandry that we do for him. This is a really cool thing to be able to get to see. Him molting. Yeah. So in the summer season, sea lions go through what is a molt. So you might have dogs or cats at home that would shed all throughout the year, while sea lions only do this once a year, and they'll actually lose all of that fur just in little patches all over. So all those little spots on him or those patches we're seeing, and that new fur is going to grow in right there. Do you guys have any questions about Townsend or anything? So one of the first behaviors all of our animals learn is what's called a target behavior, and this just means to touch. So you can actually see Sarah and Townsend demonstrating this for us, just touching the tip of his nose to her hand. And then we can actually use this to make many more complex behaviors by having them follow that hand around. We're constantly training our animals new behaviors. It provides lots of mental and physical stimulation. Just as we're always learning, we always want our animals to keep learning. Our trainers work really hard every day to build really strong and trusting relationships with our animals. As you can see, they're demonstrating a little bit of that for us there. So this behavior that she's asking for here, or you might have even seen Clark doing it earlier, jumping in and out of the water. That's called dows or porpoising. That's actually a natural behavior that they would do out in the wild to help gain speed. And it's a way that we can help provide that physical stimulation for them. And you may see we're actually setting up some stuff out here. This is what's called enrichment. I don't know if you guys have any dogs or cats at home and you give them toys, but that's kind of the same thing. So it's adding something to their environment in order to promote natural behaviors. Now I know this cheese toy may not look natural, but it's promoting them to investigate and explore new objects just as they would out in the wild. We also give our sea lions ice, as you can see there, and they find it to be really fun to play with. They can chew on it and eat it. It's really fun. It's another enrichment item we can use. Alright, does anyone
guys, we're just gonna ask if you all head up to the top of the bleachers to watch. That way you aren't really close to Townsend.